Hey, I'm back with my third Dear Preethi series, and this time I'm going to answer a question, another question I get pretty frequently, actually. So this writer said, I know HTML, CSS, JavaScript, jQuery, blah, blah, blah. I followed lots of tutorials to make simple sites, but now I'm stuck. What do I do next? What can I use to start building something? Like, I want to actually build something. I've gotten this question a lot, and I've also been in his position before as well. So you might be in the same position where you've kind of gone through a bunch of tutorials, you've learned a bunch of stuff, you maybe spent a bunch of time learning syntax and things like conditionals and data types and classes and so forth. So you kind of collected a bunch of knowledge here and there, but you're like, what's kind of next, right? You actually want to build something, but it feels like you have a bunch of disparate knowledge and you don't know how to put everything together. And I think the answer to this will be a little bit different for everyone, because there's no way I can sit here and tell you the exact steps of what to do next, but I'll kind of give you a framework for how to think about your next step once you've kind of reached this position where you're no longer just learning the basics, but you want to get to the next step. So first thing I would say, let's take a step back and remember why you want to start learning to program in the first place, right? So I think I obviously agree that everyone should learn to program, but I think it's a good starting point to understand what you personally want to get out of it. Are you trying to be the best designer? Are you trying to be a web developer? Are you trying to be a mobile developer so you can build a mobile app? Or are you trying to just use programming for your own personal hacks that you want to script up? Or are you trying to maybe build your grandma's website for her bakery? Whatever it is, think back to the time that you started programming and think back to the time of why you got so motivated to learn to program. Personally, I wanted to learn to code because I want to build this learning app where I can use certain techniques to help you remember anything that you've ever read. And I was really passionate about bringing this idea to life, and I wanted to learn the skills to bring this idea to life. So for me, it made sense to learn web development. And so depending on what you're trying to accomplish, you can figure out what you need to learn, right? And regardless of what it is, honestly, it doesn't matter. Just remember that goal and keep it in the back of your mind, because that's what's going to motivate you day to day. So that's the big picture. And then before going to that huge lofty goal that got you started, you have to think smaller, right? You have to get started somewhere. So personally, what I did was I chose a problem that I wanted to solve at work. So at the time, I was working at Andreessen Horowitz, and I wanted to build a web application that would help entrepreneurs understand software as a service metrics. So one of my focus areas when I was there was I would focus on SaaS businesses. And a lot of entrepreneurs sometimes didn't really understand how to analyze the businesses and how to understand the metrics. And I kind of wanted to create this website that would have a flow diagram that was clickable, and you can get the definitions, you can get the relationships between the different metrics and so forth. So it was a kind of pretty simple web app, one single page web app. And for you, it doesn't really matter what you pick as your first project. Honestly, just pick something that you care about enough that when stuff goes wrong, because stuff will go wrong, you're still motivated and inspired to keep going. And frankly, it's not like this is the last application you're ever going to build, right? You're just going to build a ton more. This is just the first one. So just start somewhere. Pick something that you care about. And maybe over time, you can even rebuild that better and better 2, 3, 4 times as you become a better programmer. So I had this idea of this application. So what I did was I mapped out the idea. I figured out who the target users are, what are the features I want this app to have, what is the functionality I want it to have, the look and feel of it. For me, design and the look and feel of things really motivate me. I get really motivated by seeing something beautiful. So that's something that I really want to accomplish with this application. And then I started just drawing some rough sketches, and then I started to put together just like the HTML skeleton for it. So I was like, okay, here's the header, here's the body, here's our subheaders, here's the different boxes where these metrics will go, and I had like a side navigation. So I started putting the basic HTML together, then I added a bunch of CSS for the visual stuff and making it look pretty, And then lastly, I went to go on to add JavaScript. So the core thing is I started very simple. I knew I just wanted a single page. I didn't want to have to deal with routers and all that. I had no servers or backend. It was all just front end, JavaScript, HTML, and CSS. And once I got this version out, then I started to kind of layer on other stuff. So I wanted to learn how servers work, and I was holding a lot of the logic and the data in the front end, and I wanted to really store that and have the server handle a lot of this logic and data. And so what I did was I learned Node. I went through a few tutorials and went through the documentation, and then I figured out, just like with a lot of fiddling, I learned how to add a Node server, and I got that Node server working. And I remember the moment that I got it working, I was like, oh my god, this is awesome. And then next step was I learned how to build an API, right? So I had a simple router and I built an API, and then I figured out how to get the front end to talk to the API. And that was like a big moment for me. And then I was like, okay, I'm storing a lot of my definitions and data in like a local file. I want to move this to a database. So then I went through a bunch of tutorials to learn MySQL. I learned MySQL, and then I learned how to set up a MySQL server with Node and plug those together and got those two talking to each other. And that was like another aha moment. And over time, I just kind of continued to add more and more complexity. And I even started to add an additional page to the front end. So that required me to learn how to use a router and how to navigate between those two pages. And so that was kind of like the full stack process for how I got this full stack application running. And then I also learned a little bit of basic testing after that, because I've heard that testing is good and I really want to get into the habit of doing TDD. So I learned about testing and added tests. And then finally got this application running locally. The overall key was just to get a basic web application running, to keep it manageable, right? It took me about a week to get the initial MVP of the front end working, and another week to get the back end working, because not only did I have to get it working, but I had to learn all this stuff on my own. And then the last step was to actually learn how to deploy this so that I can share with my friends or my sister or whatnot. And so what I was like doing was I was just doing a lot of Googling to understand how to like deploy a web application. And I read a bunch of tutorials on both Heroku and DigitalOcean. And I wanted to be super fancy. I wanted to be legit. So I was like, I'm going to deploy this using DigitalOcean. And frankly, it was a little bit too complicated for me at that stage. I couldn't really understand everything that was going on in some of these DigitalOcean documentation and everything. I was still just like putting things together, and it was a little bit hazy. So I was like, you know what, I'm just going to scratch this and I'm going to use Heroku, which was like, you know, it took me like half an hour to deploy on Heroku. It was like simple. And then, you know, later on as I got better, I went back and I learned how to use DigitalOcean and much more complicated deployment processes. But the lesson I learned there was like, when you're beginning, you kind of get all like shiny object syndrome and you want to use all these sophisticated tools that you hear about and stuff. But I would just say, start with the basics. Get things working. And so the simpler, the better. And really the goal is always just to finish and not make it too complex where you get like so frustrated and just like never finish and give up. So yeah, I remember when I deployed it, my like eyes lit up and I was like, it was the best feeling ever. I was sending the link to all my friends and my boyfriend, my sister and everything. And it really gave me the motivation to keep going. Whereas if I had started with this big ambitious project, I honestly probably would not have ever finished, and I would have just given up a third of the way through or something. But with the accomplishment of getting through each layer, each step along the way, I was motivated enough to kind of finish. Another thing that I do when I was in that stage of like, okay, I know a lot of things, but I don't know what to do next, is I would learn from other people by reading other people's code. So whether that's open source repos or examples that you find online, like I know the React and Redux repos, for example, have a lot of examples of sample applications. I would kind of read through those and really try to understand how people think through putting different parts of the application together. And honestly, I would copy a lot of the parts of the code that I thought was useful or that I liked or like their programming style. And honestly, it's totally okay to copy when you're learning. This is how a lot of us learn. Even some of the best programmers that I know today that are like kernel developers at Google, they started off by copying other people's code and just like playing around with it and like changing some parts and learning how that works and so forth. So it's okay to learn from other people's code and copy it as a beginner. And then over time, as you get better, you'll start to write just as good code if you practice more and more. And another recommendation I'd say is don't get stuck forever. If you ever get stuck as you're trying to build your first, second, or third, or whatever web application, that make sure you have like a process for how you go about debugging this stuff, right? First, like look at the problem that you're running into and really think about it. What could be causing it? Like write it down maybe and like think about all the possible ideas you have for what could be causing this. This really forces you to think about the problem, and next time you run into this, you'll know like, aha, I remember this because I wrote it down and I remember thinking through how to solve this problem, and it'll be much easier to solve it next time. And then other things are like learn to use a Chrome debugger in the web app. Like, I mean, that's a huge lifesaver and it's a no-brainer. And learn to use the internet. I often find so many beginners who just like get stuck and really just don't use the internet enough. And honestly, there's so many answers online. Just learn from other people. There's people have run into you. There's 99% likely chance that someone has run into you, the problem you're running into, especially if you're a beginner and building something pretty simple and basic. So leverage them, leverage the internet. And if you really can't come to any answers, ask in open source communities or free in the free code camp communities, ask on Stack Overflow, ask someone else, right? Try to find someone that you can ask. So in conclusion, there's really no simple answer to, okay, what do I do next? How do I get to the next step? How do I become a better developer? I learned all the basics. Instead, depending on your skills and depending on how much you're willing to learn and what your initial goal for learning to program was, just pick a project and build something and start small and slowly, slowly layer up. And I would say, if you've kind of done this process and you've made it through building your first application, you want to go even deeper. One thing that I did was I started researching like JavaScript books, good books that explain like basic computer science concepts or design patterns, and really read through those. And then try rebuilding your applications once you've kind of learned some of these new concepts, because you'll just see how much better you're getting day by day and week by week as you learn new things. And look, you'll as you're kind of going through this process, which is one of the hardest parts of going from like a beginner to like an advanced beginner kind of stage, you'll hit a lot of, oh my God, this sucks so much, I want to give up moments. But you'll also have those moments where like you're like, oh wow, this is so amazing, I don't want to put this down. And so every time you have that shitty moment where you're like, oh, I don't want to do this, this is really frustrating, I'm getting stuck, I feel dumb. Think about all those awesome moments you're going to have and really let those motivate you, because honestly, the programming is really about those couple of amazing moments you have that are just like, you don't want to give those up for the world, but you have to put up with a lot of shitty stuff along the way to get those. But it's totally worth it, because the feeling of like building something is just unbelievable, and I'm addicted to it now. And I hope that by building your first or second or third web application, you will get addicted to that feeling too. I think that's it for this one, and I hope you enjoyed it.